in the sold-out Sava Center in St. Louis, Missouri. And it's game time.
Showed up all right.
Booker T's most afflicted friend.
Goldust didn't ask to be electrocuted. He didn't ask for that. He didn't ask for this affliction.
Well, that was an accident.
And I don't know why people are thinking it's so funny.
An accident happened. Well, come, you gotta be kidding me. You didn't think that was funny?
Well, I'll tell you what, Triple H certainly thought Goldust was funny. Take a look at this earlier tonight.
Get the name and name. Get
Goldust didn't think it was funny either. Goldust imposing his will on the game end player.
What happened when you get electrocuted? You lose your sense of humor. And then Triple H was about to give Goldust what he had coming, and Booker T shows up. I guess better late than never, huh?
And man, did Booker T light it up. I'll tell you that right now. Booker T, the number one contender for the world's heavyweight title. The man going to WrestleMania to live his dream in less than 2 weeks to become the world's heavyweight champion. But boy, it ain't going to be easy taking this title away from the game.
Being accompanied by Booker T from Hollywood, California.
Wait.
Weighing in at 250 pounds, Goldust.
Wait on.
Quit being accompanied by Booker T. Who said anything about that?
Well, Nate is out here with Triple H.
Yeah, but I mean, Nate is Triple H's manager.
Don't you think sides should be even?
I'm just wondering if Booker T's parole officer knows he's out here.
Hey, you know, you don't let bygones be. Everybody's got little things in their past that they
tell me about yours. Tell me about yours.
You know, King,
we don't have enough time, I know.
Do you have anything in your past you'd like to talk about right now, or just read your book?
Not a thing. No. Yeah, read my book.
Right. Well, this is a non-final matchup. You're keeping score at home. It's all but personal.
That is an afflicted face right there.
I'll tell you what, Safeco Field, Enron, God, they're out of business. Safeco Field in Seattle is going to be an awesome place to be on Sunday, March the 30th.
Yeah,
it could be the biggest night in Booker T's life.
Oh, look at this.
Goldust. Oh, got a right hand in there. Tried to score the right. Caught one himself.
Now, Goldust, if he's not, I mean, you know, if that electrocution didn't fry his brain completely, he'll try to do the right thing and not make Triple H mad, but obviously his brain was fried.
Right on the jaw. Triple H, I think, was listening to Goldust and that affliction of his and walked right into the right hand.
You can't help but listen to that affliction. It's like looking at a car wreck. It's funny, JR.
A car wreck is funny, JR.
I'm listening to Goldust.
And Goldust got to come for Triple H right there. Those jabs taking down the game.
Don't make Nick get in there.
Who's laughing now? Look at Goldust. Man, he didn't come to wrestle. He came to fight.
This is not going exactly right, Triple H.
Triple H is thinking about March the 30th. He better start thinking about St. Patrick's Day here in St. Louis. Never underestimate Goldust. The bizarre one is even more bizarre than he usually is.
And that's saying something. Yeah. Oh, look out.
Nice elevation in the back body drop by Goldust. Taking down the world's heavyweight champion.
What happened to Goldust?
I think that's part of the problems in that electrocution. He's had some problems in his left arm.
His left arm?
What did you say, Goldust?
Left fist to speech?
don't think his left arm does, King, but the residual effect from, obviously, well, you and I have never been electrocuted.
At least I can speak for myself there. I once touched a 9-volt battery to my tongue.
Toss! Goldust, that left shoulder right to the ring post. The game, the cerebral assassin, doesn't miss a trick. With the hook of the leg now. Blatant Goldust got it. Shoulders up before three.
Uh-oh.
Goldust focusing on that arm, that left arm. I don't know if anybody that in this company that can game plan as good as Triple H.
That's why they call him the game. And even you call him the cerebral assassin.
Booker T getting a pretty good scouting report here as his good friend Goldie, his best friend Goldie. Fighting his way back into this thing. And Goldust, he comes from fighting stock, I'll tell you that. It's in his genes for Goldust. And there's a move. Man, I'll tell you what. Nobody does that move any better than just the great Arn Anderson, than Triple H.
See,
that's fine wrestler slam.
Actually, Booker T's getting the scout before WrestleMania. I mean, you know, look at this. Little trash talking going on there. Five times.
Like taunting and mocking.
Watch your back. Oh!
Booker T, the five-time former WCW champion. And look at Goldust now fighting. Goldust fighting his way right back in this thing, and Triple H buries that knee right in the sternum, taking the air out of Goldust, and a hard Irish whip on St. Patrick's Day. And downstairs, pedigree time. If the game hits it, it's over, but he doesn't hit it. Goldust with a roll-up. Could be a big up. No, it's not. And would it be that big an upset?
No, look out! What do you mean, would it be that big an upset?
My question.
Sure, it would be a huge upset for Goldust to beat Triple H, the World Heavyweight Champion.
This crowd behind Goldie. And Triple H, and he's a handful. They took a hard right hand, fighting right back now. And take right hand, taking Goldust down to one knee.
You know, actually, in looking at...
Oh, man!
When you look at Goldust, I don't even think he probably shouldn't even really be in the ring yet. But my sources told me that Eric Bischoff told him that if he didn't hurry up and get back in the ring, he wouldn't be employed here anymore.
Man, what an uppercut. In the true sense of the word by Goldust. Got that big right hand in, taking down the world's heavyweight champion. Bischoff is such a kind, benevolent man, isn't he? Hard shot there. Here we go. The cover. Goldust. But Bischoff will be in the ring tonight with a Texas rattlesnake that has no confidence.
That's not good.
And the ring will be surrounded by every superstar on Raw.
Oh, look out!
Goldust taking outside, his own momentum used against him. And look at Flair! Look at your buddy Nate!
Look at Nate! Go Nate! Oh, look out!
And Booker T!
Look at Booker T!
Oh, man, and Booker T knocked down Flair!
Come on!
Flair gets up, he gets knocked down again, three times!
What is wrong with Booker T?
The three knockdown reel, it's over! What the hell is that? What does... Oh, that's not a fan, that's... That's Randy Orton.
Randy Orton with a crutch.
Randy Orton lives here in St. Louis. He's been on the injured list.
He didn't put Booker T on the injured list.
Where in the hell did Randy Orton come from?
He snapped a metal crutch in half.
Man, that was what a shock. Randy Orton, I thought, well, he is on the injured list, but there's a bulldog by Goldust. Bulldog head off by Goldust, taking down the game. Goldust has countered virtually everything the game has thrown at. Oh, Goldie here tonight. Looking at the right hands there. And a little trash talking by Goldie.
Oh, no, wait a minute. No, you can't do this. You can't shatter the dreams of the World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, that is a very vulnerable situation. The game has found himself in.
No, the people are saying no, don't do it. Now look.
Well, they're the fixing again. Goldust bent over in pain from that.
What's wrong?
Flair trying to get back in the action. Booker T's been taken out by that quick shot by Randy Orton, the high knee. Along the great Harley Race, that high knee by the game. And what an effective move, Goldust knocked down. Will it be the pedigree this time?
Yes,
it will.
Yes.
Yes, it will. The pedigree. And Triple H gets the victory.
Here is your winner, Triple H.
That'll stop
You're stuttering? Wow.
I'll tell you what, Booker T got taken out by Randy Orton in that crutch. Flair trying to get involved. Flair was checkmated by Booker T. But finally, the 3-on-2 advantage.
There's your champion right there.
There's the winner. But will the game be successful at WrestleMania?
Check this out. Booker T all over the stage until Randy Orton. Randy Orton shows up with a grenade. Look out, security. He's a WWE superstar.
I thought it was a fan. They should go to jail if he did. If it was a fan, I'm not so sure this kid shouldn't be in jail anyway. And then the pedigree.
Who are you talking about, Booker T?
I'm talking about Randy Orton. Pedigree, I don't care who you are, Booker T or Goldust or anybody else, you're going to stay down.